Hello everyone, I'm Anindo Bhattacharji. This is from School of Management Sciences, Varanasi. And today we have the privilege of having with us Professor Roberto Bilaslavo, who is the Vice Dean of University of Primorska, Slovenia. Professor Bilaslavo is one of the authorities in the field of knowledge management. And recently he has been doing some very exciting work in the field of wisdom and trying to link it with management. So thank you very much, Roberto, for being with us. Tell me something about what brought you from a field like knowledge management to something like wisdom.
Thank you for that introduction. It was very nice to say that such an important figure in knowledge management. But if I'm going back to your question, I would say that just at a certain point, I didn't find anything that could be really, really interesting, to research inside knowledge management field. Somehow I was thinking that everything that could be really said and that can be really important was already said by really authorities in knowledge management. So I was thinking that maybe wisdom can be something that it give you much more space, that we can really bring more new things and more important things to management and leadership. So basically that was the reason.
What brought you to this particular conference, and what really interested you in this conference?
I think that what is really different about that conference, if you compare with the other conferences, that really brings here people that probably you cannot meet at any other conference. So I've said so many Swami and Baba and other sages, probably you cannot meet them in the conference in USA or UK or any other part of the Europe. So that was the different perception, different point of view that was brought to the conference. That was really interesting for me because I had just the first experience to meet these kind of people yesterday evening. And for me that was really somehow maybe a challenge, you know, to meet these people and to listen what they want to say and what they have to say.
You spoke about a very interesting thing today, the three levels of leadership today. Which actually is from personal leadership, private leadership, and then public leadership. Can you elaborate a bit upon the three levels and how it is really relevant to the present context of business that the world is facing right now?
Okay, let's say that if you want to be really a good leader, then probably you need to be good on all three levels, okay? So that is a supposition. You need to be able to self-manage yourself. You need to be able to manage the relationship with your co-workers as well. You need to be able to manage the relationship with all other stakeholders that are going to be around the organization. The point is that a lot of time we just somehow forget that it's not just the public side of the leadership or the personal side of the leadership that's really important that count, but it's the private side of the leadership that count. I think that the best way to say it, you can see people, they are going up and up inside the organization. They're coming to the top of the organization. They are very well, or they are very able to speak to the public and to somehow solve the problems with the co-workers. But inside them, they are in the big trouble. They have a feeling they are alone. So that is the best, that's not good self-management. That's at least my point of view. So you can be very good outside on what the people see, but you have a lot of problems inside you. And at a certain point of time, they probably, because you have that problem inside you, you will have also problems outside. It just depends on the time. For some people, that can be in short term. For some people, that can be in long term.
So what has been your experience so far consulting a lot of companies? You being coming from the Eastern European side, that is Slovenia, I guess. So what has been your experience of consulting the companies in Slovenia and outside Slovenia with your wisdom and with your knowledge management consulting?
Okay, I didn't make for now. I didn't make any consulting based on my wisdom research. I was mainly involved in knowledge management projects or wisdom and mission development. And what I said today, it was a nice talk with the top management, and we really elaborate, you know, very complex, very nice vision, mission statements, you know. But I have always a feeling that was something that we elaborated for, you know, for stakeholders, for public, for employees. But sometimes I think that they completely knew what they want. But after that, if you came to the organization, to the company, after 1 year or 2 years, you didn't see any of that vision and mission things that you just developed before. So even if the process was made in the way that they will, all of them, they were involved in the process. It wasn't just me and I would say the CEO. They, all of them, they were involved in the process. But at the end, everything was nice. We were all happy with what we developed. But it just somehow it didn't make an impact, a true impact in the organization. I cannot say that what that happened in all organizations, but in most of them.
All right. Can you just tell me some about something about the work that you do with Professor Bernard McKenna also a lot? Probably you work on a metastatic model of leadership or wisdom. So can you tell us a bit about that also?
Yeah, okay. Bernard McKenna, we just started to work together based on some emails that we shared with each other. And from that point on, we just found that we have a lot of things that are very common. So point of view about how we can understand wisdom, what kind of dimension can be important for wisdom development. Based on that, we are just starting to write something together. And he's much more, I would say, empirical side oriented. So he's trying to go from theoretical model that I just developed. He's trying to go to the empirical side, you know, really to measure how much wisdom can change leadership, or how is the impact of wisdom on leadership. I'm a little bit back on that, but we will see.
What has been your experience of consulting about wisdom in management with the corporate people in general, people who come from practice? What has been your experience when you talk with such people, when you talk with them about wisdom? What is normally their response?
I would say that I would be very careful, first of all, to use the word wisdom. I think that would be understand much more if I'm going to just to speak about the four dimension, okay? Because if I stay in the four dimension, they already knew something about that, and that is much more closer to what they're thinking. If I'm starting to speak about wisdom, then probably they would say, okay, you are a nice guy, but okay, I have no time, so no. So probably I would just not go directly to speak about wisdom, but I would like to speak about the four dimension, and I would like to speak how we can somehow help them to develop, you know, from one stage to another.
So what do you think is the hunch? What is the problem? Like, in spite of having so many recent uncertainties encircling the business scenario globally, still people are resistant to such wisdom ideas. Why do you think? What could be the reason?
I think that one of the reasons is probably because a lot of businessmen and leaders, they want to achieve objectives in the short term, you know. They need to bring return on investment, they need to bring profit. And because all other people expect that from them, they are not able to wait for something. They are not able to wait for the process that's going on. They would like just to bring something they can, okay, just solve that. That's my problem now. Please help me to solve that problem. And I not want to wait for that for another 1 year or 2 years, okay? So that's probably one of the reasons. I think that they are very smart guys. They know a lot. They comprehend what's important. But I said today, it's a big gap between what I know and what I will do it. So somehow this gap is very difficult to go beyond that.
What do you think? Today you talked about the Aristotelian wisdom, and you talked about his vision of eudaimonia, right? So can you just tell me a bit about that?
I think that's just another point of view about wisdom. As you know, if you take this spiritual point of view that is based on, I would say, philosophical tradition in India, then probably the point of view about wisdom is a little bit different, I suppose. But if you go in the Western, then I would say the old Greek philosophers talk a lot about wisdom, and they started to define what wisdom is. And before they started to define what wisdom is, they just started to find what is our existence. So what is our main objective that we need to achieve during our, you know, life? And they just say that if you want to be really a fully human being, you need to achieve eudaimonia, what they call it, that we can translate like human flourishing, or I would say I can be translate like a true happiness. And so if you want to achieve true happiness, then I need a bunch of virtues. But among that bunch, wisdom is the most important one. And it's for the simple reason, because if you don't have wisdom, then what is your strong part, what is your virtue, it can be your weakness.
So what do you want, what is the point that you want to make? Today you are making a presentation, you said that I want to speak more on wisdom and not about the spiritual wisdom. So tell me one thing. Do you think spirituality is the broader thing or wisdom is the broader thing?
Nice question. I don't know what the proper answer on that. But I think that we can speak about wisdom and we go outside spirituality. That's a little my point. So I can speak about wisdom and I can link it to the spirituality, but I can speak about wisdom and I cannot link it to the spirituality.
Is it like wisdom is a more acceptable term in all domains than spirituality? That is what you are trying to say.
That, from my point of view, yes. But it's really, you know, you can go to speak about wisdom from different, many different points of view. But if you're going to speak about spirituality, then probably it's just one way how we can speak about it.
Okay. It was really nice talking to you, Roberto. And we would really wish that you keep coming to this campus again. Thank you.